Hi everyone, how are you guys doing today? I hope everyone is doing fine. Welcome back to another thrilling episode of gameplay Get Even. This is episode 2. I hope you enjoyed the episode 1 that I done yesterday, and let's keep exploring this new place I'm at now. And I hope you guys will enjoy this gameplay video while you are playing your own games on your own time. And without further talking, let's head back to the game. So right now I am in I woke up from my sleep, something I might have been dreaming, or the guys who were on the TV here just now, they might have been gone inside my mind and exploring my own past. I don't know what they did to me, but I've just woken up here and I haven't got my weapons or my phones. It's not here with me, so let's keep exploring and see if we find anything helpful. The room is full of monitors. The music that plays all the time here while something big is going to happen, it makes me scared all the time. I mean, it's not scared, but it gives very different kind of feeling. Okay.
Wait, a gun. My gun.
This is my gun.
Security, Mr. Black. A token of trust.
How can I trust you when you knock me out and put this thing on my head?
To explain, your memory was damaged in the explosion, leaving two questions that you came to us
to answer. Why were you there?
And who was the girl?
I know why I was there. To save the girl.
Then we are making progress.
Please.
Proceed.
Proceed with what? Hello?
At least I got one of my weapon back, which is good. Now I can defend myself from anything that comes around. So I just discovered that it wasn't a dream, whatever happened. It was just someone knocked me out and took all my weapons. And they have put something on my head. It might be something similar to this. There is a blueprint of it. I still don't have my phone. I need to be very cautious now because I don't have my phone. Remember that you can equip a smartphone by holding. Okay, now I can have my phone by holding triangle. Okay, there's something around here. This is your fault, okay. Oh, there's someone. Oh, that's scary shit.
September 2000. Wait, that was... When was that?
There could be someone in here too, yep. Let me take a picture of him. There's one more here because there's still a green light on my phone, but I can't see him inside. Okay, it's in here. This is the one.
Analysis complete. Memory unit RR003. Codename Pandora Savant.
Looks like the same thing I'm wearing.
Yeah, the evidence collection in this area is completed now. Earlier I couldn't do it because I couldn't take out my phone. There's something more around here.
Hey! Hey friend, over here! You got out?
Oh, yeah.
How did you get out? You can't leave me here.
Just hang on. What's going on here? Where are we?
Please, you've got to help me. The switch there, it opens this door. You have to help me.
This switch here? Let's see. It doesn't work. Nope, it's not working. Maybe I need to manually open it like last time. Nothing in there. Let's try now.
Thank you. You won't regret this. You won't regret this at all.
Remember, your actions will have consequences. Okay. I hope I have done the right thing by letting him go. Horrors of the asylum. Mm-hmm. This is the same asylum I made. Built in 1962 to house 500 inmates, later as asylum, had over 2,000 patients at its peak in the mid-80s. 15 years later, the facility was forced to close due to allegations of numerous ex-patients, together with series of newspaper articles regarding sucking and unorthodox treatment used by director of the institution, Dr. William Benway. Benway held the radical belief that all mental disorders are caused by bodily infections and that the most direct way to cure a patient is by removing the offending infection. Reports suggest he would pull patients' teeth out, and if he deemed the treatment unsuccessful, would frequently remove other parts too, including testicles, uteruses, ovaries, and stomachs. He claimed the method had a 90% cure rate, but in reality, many of the patients died which Benway would refer to as the ultimate cure. Benway and his methods eventually gave rise to Leiter's asylum's nickname, the Hospital of Lost Teeth. Okay, that's not something good to happen to the patients, but it's a real thing.
I told you to ignore them, Mr. Black. If the treatment is to succeed, I need your cooperation.
Yeah, sure.
But it used to happen a lot in past around the world too. People used to mistreat the patients in asylum. Let me see my map. Oh, there's someone in there. Where's my gun? This guy I just rescued, and you are coming to kill me. What's wrong with you? Looks like there's more peasant in here. I just came in through this door, but it's shut now. Why is all the doors shutting behind me? Looks like someone doesn't want me to come back.
Although your memory has been affected, your twitch response remains intact. Pure muscle memory. Fascinating.
What is this? Place is filled with runaways, criminals, ex-military. Who the fuck am I? And why the fuck am I armed?
I understand your curiosity, but there will be time for questions later, Mr. Black. Please, proceed. See? You're more than capable
of figuring it all out.
What's going on? Something feels off.
Yes, you appear to be experiencing
a slight temporal anomaly. You're remembering events in the wrong order. It's just your mind trying to make sense
of it all.
Perfectly normal.
So I'm having a flashback from past. Looks like something. I can see a small gun or something on top of that table. Oh, there it is.
Was this all your fault?
Do you remember how to use the weapon?
Not really.
Why don't you approach the firing line?
Yeah, this is my gun I had before, which got disappeared. Press R1 again to straighten the Gurner gun. Set height.
And move forward to continue.
Press X to scan. Okay, there's more flashback happening like before. Oh, this is something new because
I'm back in the ADS building.
Technically, you're not even there, Mr. Black.
Out of nowhere, it just came in.
Thank you. try and push this parameter. Put your gun away. So do dreams, Mr. Black, until you wake up. That's the best way I can explain it.
But Pandora is still not fully capable
of simulating human behavior. I would advise against creating too much disturbance.
Every time you kill
someone, you rewrite the memory, which may cause distortion.
Stop messing about, return to your post.
So earlier this guy told me not to kill anyone, but there are threats on my map, so I will have to deal with them one way or another.
Thank you.
They have seen me again. Finished. So my ammo is finished now. I don't know what to do.
Above you are the research labs. I believe that's where you need to go.
A warning.
You may come across Roger Howard, the CEO.
He was personally overseeing the development of the corner gun.
The man never sleeps, although it's late.
He may well be around.
There was only one option to choose for, which was Duel. Let's go. The voice on the phone says that. Looks like the floor is cleared now. Let me explore and try and see if I can find anything here that's useful.
don't remember the code to this door. How do I get through?
The memory of the code is still there, Mr. Black. You just can't quite access it. Explore your surroundings. The mind has funny ways of helping us recall.
I don't understand.
You don't need to, Mr. Black. You just need to look around.
I can see that the Riser's Pound has number 7 on it. It could be one of the numbers. Nine. Four. That's all the pictures I can see around. Maybe that's the number 7945. Let me go and see if it works or no. Yeah, 7945. 7. Seven, nine, four, five. Yeah, that's it.
You didn't just steal
the corn again. You destroyed
their servers, erased their data, wiped the corn
again from existence.
You're good at your job, Mr. Black. I'll give you that.
This Robert Ramsey must have paid well.
Corner gun.
I'm afraid I've been watching you since the moment you entered the building. Your work is impressive, but the show is over. You have my property, and I want it back. Nothing personal, you understand. Security. Kill him.
that's all done.
I've seen enough. I'm pulling you out.
But Howard, he escaped.
There's nothing you can do about it now. I'm pulling you out.
Okay, looks like I've successfully completed a mission except killing Howard.
That's it. Stay with us, Mr. Black. I'm pulling you out.
I thought this was a simulation. I was there. I could feel it. The pain.
It felt
real because your mind perceived it to be. Injuries sustained within the Pandora will have the same effect on your brain as those sustained without.
Now, stop thinking, Mr. Black.
Clear your mind while I bring you out.
I feel like I'm gonna throw up.
A natural response. It will become easier the more we proceed. If it helps,
I have prepared a little
gift for you.
What are you talking about?
Outside in the corridor. You see the lines of computer code.
All the ones and zeros.
Please, approach and proceed.
Not that again.
Okay, I was here earlier. But I can't get out. Getting transported to somewhere else again.
Hey, where am I now? Is this another memory?
Not quite. Consider this a filing cabinet, Mr. Black, of all the evidence you gather. We'll make sense of it eventually. Any information filed by the Pandora is accessible for you in this room. Each board represents a different memory. Give it a try. Look at a couple of boards and see what happens. Any connections or links your mind may have made, even unconsciously, are recreated visually by the Pandora. I'm rather proud of this feature. You can study the investigation further or return to the asylum when you're ready. Just use the photo in the middle of the room.
This is the one I just did. And more.
This.
So this is the place where I have all my works saved, like I did that kidnapping in the beginning, and then this one on building B, the current one here. That means this third mission might have just been finished. So if I want to go back, I will just press O square here, but I think I will continue that next mission, whatever it is, in next gameplay. So anyway, thank you very much for watching this gameplay with me and being with me. It was a very tough mission for me because I couldn't figure out things quite nicely. Anyway, I got through eventually. I hope you guys enjoyed it and it will be helpful for you guys when you play this game on your own time. I will catch you very soon. See you. Bye.